some truffle cheese here. Here's the black pepper, green, cumin, cayenne, Gouda. Love it. Good. Ladies, how are you? Good, thank you. So we found our favorite, which is a truffle one. If I go for a medium Gouda.
So would you like to taste it?
For sure.
Okay. So there you go.
Good. And this is a medium?
This one is actually more medium. So it's a little bit more aged. So how much can I get for you?
I want a wheel.
You want a wheel or a half a wheel?
I want a wheel. At what point did you milk this? Did you do it this morning or was it yesterday?
Yeah, I start normally at 3 o'clock.
3 this morning?
Yeah. What is really important cheese making is feeding the cows. When you're feeding not right, the cream in the milk need to be soft and flavorful.
That means that you have your own cows,
yeah,
and you know what your cows are eating. How long have you been doing this?
More than 50 years.
More than 50 years? You started in Holland doing it?
Yes.
And then when did you come to Alberta?
And I came to Alberta in 95.
But Alberta is not a place where people would say this is dairy country or cheese country. So is it not hard to come and do it here?
Everyone said you cannot make cheese here. He said, what? Can you not make cheese here? Said you can make cheese everywhere in the world. Depends on what you feed the cow.
You can make cheese everywhere in the world. Depends on how you feed the cows. I love it. So are these big ones Gouda?
Yes, Gouda. The fermentation starts later. Still the rennet working. Still more liquid come out of it. That do the rennet. And then we make a skin around.
So why do you put weight on it then? It's just to get the shape of the cheese to go?
The way out that is between the curds, they go out now, that take at least 24 hours more. It's still working, become still little liquid come out. But the skin is there, it's breathing.
How is Alberta accepting Alberta cheese? Because we're not known for cheese, are we?
There was no cheese here. When we go first for looking still, we start in Ontario, Manitoba, here, and British Columbia.
Why Alberta?
There's more space here. For farming, it's difficult in BC, but is it the same as in the Netherlands?
And therefore, you have a bit of a challenge because you sell your cheeses at the farmers' markets.
Yeah.
Yes, but it's also available in stores, right?
Oh, yeah. We have a wholesaler worldwide and restaurants, also in Banff and all that stuff there.
Look at that. So what we have here is September 2012. This is what they call extra old Gouda?
Extra old Gouda. Better than Parmesan.
Better than Parmesan. I have learned from you now that the quality of the milk and the cows is what really sets the standard for the quality of the cheese that comes out. When you look at the cheeses behind you and years that you've worked to get to this point, what is your favorite part of your business?
I like my cows more than I do this. But in Holland, how you get farming, that is a really hard point. But I start farming with one cow and growing. And when you get to that, how you can survive, just cheese making. I had never do that, but I know it from my parents. And I started cheese making, and the guy went to the world contest, and I was world champion.
You were world champion?
World champion in 1972.
If I get a wheel of your cheese here, and I know nothing about cheese, how do I know it's a good cheese?
You don't know that, first of all. Normally I have a sound. There's this one, I hear it. How it is. That is a totally solid cheese. There's no air in, nothing. I can pick another one with air. Then maybe you hear the difference. You know nothing?
No.
Okay, and what I then do then for somebody, then I drill a hole in.
Mm-hmm.
Then you taste it. Oh, tastes a little different. What has happened? Huh? Maybe temperature, maybe feeding the cows, maybe something. Anyway, it's different.
Everyone is different. That's the key. That's absolutely the key, because if you're an artisan cheesemaker, whatever the ingredients is you've got to work with determines what the quality is going to be.
And always room temperature, never in the fridge.
Never in the fridge?
Never in the fridge.
I thought you need to keep cheese in the fridge.
That depends on what type of cheese.
Here you go. So the blue cheeses?
All the soft cheeses, all the cheese that is processed, all the cheese that is made in the factory, that is right away packed, culture die.
Yeah.
You're not protecting more. It is always at room temperature. It is 5 years at room temperature.
A trip to Red Deer and to Sylvan Lake is not worth it unless you make a stop at Silver Star Cheese and you get really Alberta, true Alberta cheese. Look at that. I didn't know Alberta made cheese. I kept on looking for somebody in Alberta to make cheese. And Jan, you shared a very amazing experience with us today. Not only do we love your cheese, but what we really see is your passion and your hard work. And I can just see you going, 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 going. I am so glad we can tell the rest of the world how great your cheese is and also a little bit about your story.